Okay, thank you very much for inviting me for this workshop. So today I'm presenting modeling administration discretion using quadrilateral answer set programming. So it's a joint work with Mar and Jose Antonio, which are lawyer professors at Universidad Rey Juan Carlos and Sascha. So we already discussed a lot about formal representation and automated reasoning. So I will skip most of the slides of the talk because it's a very short presentation. So the problem is that formal representation are not able to represent ambiguity or administrative discretion, as we will see is important case in these topics. So our proposal is SLOW, which is a framework based on CASP. It's a non-monotonic reasoner that evaluates answer set programs with constraints. It allows modeling legal rules involving ambiguity. For instance, we will see an example of awarding a school place in Comunidad de Madrid, where to determine the proximity to a family home, there is a case where if there is four major, you can avoid this requirement. SLOW supports reasoning and infer conclusion based on these rules, even if they have ambiguity. And which is really important, provides justifications and of the inference in natural language. So a little background of SCASP. SCASP is based on stable model semantic. The main feature is that it supports non-stratifier negation. With these non-stratifier negations, you can define different words. In these examples, we have that Bob on Saturday either goes to the opera or stays home. And we can specify this rule saying that opera Saturday is true if not home Saturday is false, I mean holds, which means that home is false, and vice versa. Homes is true if not opera holds. So we have two possible models. In one model, opera is true, and in the other model, home is true. So we can make with this non-stratifier negation more complex examples. In these examples, we have that also we know that Bob will stay at home on Monday, and is forbidden, so it's not allowed to go to the opera if the friend with the baby is coming this day. And we know that the baby is coming on Tuesday. So we make the query, and then the system will provide the constraints which days is not allowed to go to the opera, or we know that Bob is not going to the opera. But as we said, it's important that we can obtain the justification tree for these conclusions. So we see that here we have in natural language the results. So we will see how it works later in some examples. So SCASP has been applied in different fields to model event calculus, in explainable artificial intelligence with these features that we already saw, but for the physician advisor system, and also in knowledge-driven natural language understanding. There are some features that I skip for this talk, but they are available in the paper. So the main contribution of this work is a set of patterns that make it possible to translate the legal rules, and also patterns to generate the justification in natural language. The frameworks provide evidences, is applied for the legislation and represent ambiguity and so on. So they are related work that I will skip, but I will present today less breaking use case, which is the case of Novak Djokovic. We already know, most of us, that he has dropped from Australia because administrar discretion, which is something that we will see it's possible to define in ASP. So here we have the five patterns that we are presenting. The first two are trivials. I mean, the second one, exception for applying with negation, is, I mean, in prologue is not sound, the implementation of negation and failure. So, I mean, I will say that in ASP and in our proposal is more elegant. But the more important part is how we define ambiguity, discretion to act, and unknown information. In these cases, we generate different models, different words. In the first one, for the force major, we have two possible models. In one, we assume that force major holds, and in the other, doesn't. For discretion to act, is more or less similar. And in unknown information, that's happened, except if we introduce evidences for the truth hold or the face fall for this information. So if we are not introducing this information, we have the two possible situations. The framework consists in three main modules. The first one is the legislation rules, which is they are straightforward rules that a simple log. And here we have this the even loops. I mean, where you we generate the two possible models for instance for force. Here we have the implementation for the discretion, and here with the negation we have the negation of the exceptions. The second one is to introduce the patterns for the natural language processing, I mean for the justifications. So here, instead of introduce this information as part of the programs, we introduce only the predicate, which is sorted, so you avoid most of the typos, and then with these rules you can generate the translation. And finally, we have the module for the students, where we introduce the informations and the evidences, also negated to introduce that it's not the case that this student is a foreign student. So let me go to the table one. Here we see some examples and evaluations with information. So in this case, this student meets all the requirements and has also the certificate, so we'll obtain the place. This student doesn't because has not a certificate. Here, yes, because it has one of the requirements. Here, we don't know some of the information, but we are assuming that in this case, some of this information will be true. Here, yes, because we are with a specific criterion, but in this case, this specific criterion is illegal. So important is that we can make a priori deduction. So we can ask if the student one meets the requirements, and we obtain the justification for this case. And also we can make a posterior deduction. In this case, we can ask which is the case, if a student obtain a place or not, assuming that it's not possible to assume the force major scenario, and in this case, the student number three will not get a place. Also, we can ask for the student number six why he doesn't obtain a place, and we see that that is the case because this criteria is illegal because discriminate based on race. So to conclude, CASP is able to model discretion to act, ambiguity, and unknown information, is exhibit the property for modeling vague concepts. The deduction based on SLOW allows considering different conclusions, multiple models, and reason about the set of these conclusion and models. For the future, we want to extend this with criterials, exploring the constraint solver of SCASP. And also we want to extend SLOW considering epistemic specification, which make it possible to analyze what is true in all of some of the models with partial model sharing assumptions. So with that, I conclude my presentation. So thank you very much.
All right, we have questions in the room, maybe. All right, first question from the audience. Question is from Thorne. I assume you can see it.
It's not the same. I mean, disjunction is when you have two different rules. So one is true if something or the other. So the disjunctive information, if I understand properly the question, is that you have different models. So you have different scenarios. So there is information that is true in one model, but not in the other.
All right, let's call for questions. Otherwise, we are ready to move on to